So a food network called Bon Appetit posted a video where Philadelphia chef Tyler Akins teaches 20 million viewers how to prepare a bowl of pho. Now he gives all the wrong instructions while twirling the noodle spaghetti style. He claims that sriracha ruins the flavor. I really don't know if he's trying to say that shit's too spicy. He claims that pho is on the rise to replace ramen, as if there can only be like one Asian phenomenon at a time. And for a review on Vietnamese cuisine, you would invite the producers or pick some shit, I don't know, Vietnamese, or Japanese, or Chinese, or someone they can't tell the difference between. Is there a reason why the YouTube video still shows a man who cannot pronounce my father's name correctly? Why did they show someone who looks at a bowl of pho like salvation? What is religion to a starving man? What does a white god and good table manners mean to a country at war with itself? Tyler, have you ever made soup from bones? Fed the children first and still starved the family? Maybe we drown our soup in sauce because we remember a history seasoned in tears. Remember when uncles bit their wrists just to taste the salt? See, even cooking becomes its own trauma. The grip of the ladle, both trigger warning and deliverance to an immigrant. I've never seen my father cry unless he talked about his own father. And my father can be a quiet man. My mother, on the other hand, tells me, and I quote, that the universe will give you a pimple for every speck of rice you don't eat off the plate. Yeah, she's a funny woman, right? She thinks if she smiles for the interview, the employer won't notice the accent, but they always do. They know she does not exist. They confuse her eyes for a story they do not know. I remember one night, my mother would make me a week's worth of pho, only to have it called worms. The food for savages, but the same white boys who now post my culture on Instagram, but my food is not a fashion statement. My father hates talking on an empty stomach, so really, we can only ever speak over dinner. My food be a bridge made of chopsticks, be the bread blessed by ancestors. How many have died for me to live on for them? My food be a survivor's guilty pleasure, and I am tired of listening to my history be told by college professors who do not look like me. I am tired of my bullies asking me to try an overpriced dish that my mom makes better. And I want to see a day where my future son can smile wide and not be called chink or coin slot or the failures of America. And he will tell me about his first day at school, where all the other kids tell him how lucky he is to have parents to cook him a meal. And he'll look at me smiling. For those who don't know what it's like to be me, whoever consumed this story,